Deponia with me, Demox. When we last left off, Cletus has arrived.
Yay!
Boo. One thing, and we have to get the doohickey. So, we're gonna do just that. Hello? Awesome.
Hello? Anyone out there?
No. Just the wind.
That was to be expected. Not even the wind knows how to behave here.
Right, that's that's Cletus's room.
There's a handwritten label on the bottle. My dearest honey bear.
Honey bear.
I've packed some of my special homemade shampoo for you. It contains the secret ingredient that gives you such a glorious full head of hair. So take good care of it. After all, your baby brother had to do without his breakfast for it.
That's the wrong button. Well, we now know it's the next door, so, help? I want the towel.
Hey, Bozo, you old
pirate. Go ahead and say it.
Huh? Nah, how can you be a pirate without the cutter? I was gonna say, you old liver spot repository. You better get that. You don't want to shock Gol into another coma as soon as she wakes up, do you?
Not really.
Cletus is here. He's moved into the room next door. He's probably looking for gold.
Did he see you?
See me? Yeah. You're talking to the master of disguise, the human cloak of invisibility. Sneakity sneaker, the sneak attack on the soft underbelly of injustice.
Hey, keep it down in there.
Well, you,
Rufus, maybe it would be better if you stayed in the room for now.
Rubbish! You want a plasma dimmy thingy? Well, I will get you a plasma thingy.
But Rufus...
Shh! You don't want Cletus to hear you, do you?
Anyway.
Now, don't you think we should get dressed?
I can't. My clothes are in the laundry.
And if I bring them to you, will you finally cover up then?
Why should I?
After all, there's a lady present.
Goal? She seems rather absent to me. And as long as she is, why would you begrudge me a little leg room? You have no idea how hard it is to find pants that fit in my size.
All right. There's an absent lady present. But is that a reason to asphyxiate her? She's already blushing.
Rufus? I think you're standing on her breathing tube.
Huh? Whoops. Whatever. This isn't about any stupid tubes. This is about,
leg room.
Exactly. Not that I have any less leg room. I'm thinking about Doc, too.
Don't worry about my leg room, boy.
Speaking of which, how come we never see your legs, Doc?
Let's just leave it that. Don't worry.
I love that. Point out. Why would we see your legs? Literally, at no point do we ever actually see your legs.
Your nakedness is throttling my sense of aesthetics. No, no, don't. Especially when you do that thing with me. You must be freezing.
Not really. There's a draft from the holes in the window, but the putrid air from the heater balances it out.
What if the heater goes out?
Why don't you just tell
me what you're planning?
Then you won't have to constantly come up with some crazy scheme.
Yeah, but where's the fun in that? I mean, where's the kick? Where's the challenge? I need your towel.
Okay.
No, no, don't.
You just don't know what you want.
My eyes!
I'm telling you, you're gonna catch the whooping fox.
Rubbish. My tongue would be completely blue. I would have a cough, the sniffles, and a
blue tongue, cough,
sniffles, fever.
Got it.
this. You aren't planning to infect me with whooping pox, are you?
I only said you would catch it. How you do that will be my little secret. do whatever you want.
Okay.
Stop doing that. Stop doing that.
Except that thing with your legs. Anything but that. Wasn't that awesome before?
I suppose.
Aw, you're unhappy, aren't you?
Unhappy doesn't even come close.
I certainly would be in your place. After all, you slept through all the cool action. Come on, give me a smile.
Why should I? My cutter is wrecked.
Aw, it's not the end of the world.
The world is ending.
Not until tomorrow morning.
And there's nothing to eat here. And I'm hungry.
Complain. Uh-huh. Almost sound like my ex-girlfriend, Tony. Or my ex-best friend, Wenzel. Or anybody else who spent a lot of time with me.
And that doesn't make you think.
A whole lot more would have to happen to make me think.
Yeah, that was my impression.
Uh-huh. You just said I'm a moron.
Sorry, I've gotta go. Don't take it personally. It's just your disgusting appearance. My eyes are smarting already.
I'm gonna talk to Doc.
Hey, Doc!
For the 1,000th time, Rufus, you'll only get your ball back when you tell me how the leftover pudding got into my particle accelerator.
First of all, that wasn't pudding. And second... How's the calibration coming?
It would go a lot faster if you...
Got a plasma exchange whoop-de-doo mammoth for relay, right?
Exactly.
What would you ever do without me?
A lot of things.
What am I supposed to get again?
A mammoth fur...
Whoop-de-doo.
Plasma...
Just kidding. Of course, I'm supposed to get a plasma exchange whoop-de-doo mammoth fur relay. I would never forget such an important assignment.
Yeah. How are you going to lose?
You've kept me from my vital professional mission for too long.
The farther you are from the room, the less we can bother you.
Uh-huh.
She's unconscious again, but this time it's part of the plan.
Yeah, we want the conscious at some point. I think changing my plans. No, some strange reason, I don't know why anyone Cleese dressed. I don't want Bozo dressed.
Hello, reception?
Always at your service. What's your room number?
Room 3.
Ah, I finally got a hold of you. I've got a number of complaints about you here. Noise disturbance, odor disturbance, regular disturbance, molestation. Oh, no. Wait, those are about me. Whatever. More importantly, you still haven't paid for your delivery. Why do you need all those chickens anyway?
Did I say room 3? Of course. I meant...
Okay, so room 3 is the Swami guy.
Room 1.
Oh, the inspector again. If this is about the bedding, those aren't spots, just a pattern. Which reminds me, do you often sleep with your mouth open? If so, then...
Yeah, fine.
Yeah.
This isn't about the bedding.
Ah, all the better. How can I help you?
I would like to dine now.
You've got guts. I like that. Have you selected something for the menu? You have kept your menu, haven't you?
Oh, the menu?
Yes, you got it here at reception. You are Inspector Cletus, aren't you?
Of course I'm Inspector Cletus. Who else? Slimy hair, slimy character, has no appetite anymore, would rather talk about something else. Cletus, yes, in the flesh.
Uh-huh. What's a dime?
Oops. Wrong number.
No problem.
Okay. That was a bing. So we got some sort of clue from that. Ah, intish. Into the restaurant. The upper bottle away from the restaurant. Reception. Fang Citizen for lunch. Ah, right. We have plans. We have a methodology. And I want more loot.
Ooh. Wow. It's been a while since I had so much money in my hands. Or any money at all. There's nothing but broken stuff in here. And now that I took his money, that's what he is. Broke.
Okay, so that's not going to give me anything else. Technically, I have Bozo's clothing. But I won't put it on until it's cold. Seer's room, the closet, dark room, door room, doctor room. Oh! I found a long haired platypus. Cool. Alright, he's stood there. That's not gonna be funny. Ah, I need to lure him away from his room. Or should I say I need to lure him back into his room. Right.
Hello, reception? Always. Room 1.
Oh, how can I help?
I would like to order something sinfully expensive sent to my room.
Actually, we don't offer any services in this hotel. But if you want, I can simply tack on a horrendous surcharge to your bill. The item will then appear as an accounting error.
Oh, that would be very nice.
Oh, no problem. I would have done it anyway. Standard procedure, if you know what I mean. Did I do anything else to you?
Is our laundry done yet?
How should I know?
I thought it was part of the service.
Ah, the service. Yes, I've heard a lot about that, but nothing that has convinced me that it actually exists. I suggest you pick up your laundry yourself, instead of relying on some mystic New Age pipe dream. Did I do anything else to you?
I would like to speak to my assistant.
Yeah, of course. I'll send him down to your room if that's all right.
Oh, why don't you? And tell him to sing the Dumb Bum song on the way.
I'll pass that along.
Thank you. At last. Now reception should be free. I just have to make sure I don't run into that Oppenbot.
If I open the door, it's gonna...
Yes. What is it?
You summoned me to your room.
No, I did not.
But you did. You just called to reception.
I would certainly know what I have or have not done. I'm starting to think you're suffering from acute processor overload.
But I heard your voice myself.
If you aren't sure what my voice sounds like, then
listen to me well.
Never bother me again without a good reason. Understood?
Yes, of course. But
what?
I heard your voice. I'm on reception.
Ah, the gold.
What?
Most guests are gone because of the menu, you know? And our old cook is even in prison because of
the... Can I have the menu or not?
Lickety shit. You just have to sign this waiver form for...
Ah! That's a snot rag.
Yeah, well, there are just too many possibilities for being harmed by our meals. A form would be way too much work. And our lawyer suffers from depression. So we just copy the guest signature onto the appropriate waiver later.
Very economical thinking.
And please sign with a W in front.
Excuse me? Rufus?
Yeah. The drawer for R is stuck.
Oh. Of course.
Thanks.
I tell you, Alright.
Here comes the dum bum the dum bum the dum bum the dum bum.
Well, folks, I've gotta go.
I'll go and.
Finally.
Yay. We now have a menu. I think. Yes, we have a menu. Now we shall order something from the menu. Let's sign him up for lunch. I still don't know what this nut's for. We'll do something with that nut eventually. Bye bye. Oh, I I'm much better than you at this. I also need Bozo to get his clothes on, because we won't start the procedure probably until Bozo's clothed.
Hello, reception? Room 1.
Oh, how can I help you?
I would like to dine now.
Have you selected something from the menu?
I'll have the fish brain stew, please.
All right, it's your life. Meal will be served at 12 on the dot. Please be on time. Dining room is guest to cockroaches, and the stew loves to chase those critters around the room.
Yes, fine. Please notify me in good time.
All right, who am I to deny such a courageous man his last wish?
Remember, room 1, Cletus.
12 o'clock, fish brain stew, shovel, trash bag, all written down.
12 o'clock, understood. Thank you
very much. That's mean, Rufus. You are really mean to your other half. Hey, what's this? Take care of this. And for that we need to obtain a 1/3 screwdriver. Alright. Oh, well. Cletus backup costume, so which means I need to pay. Oh, God, the gigantic is just expanding! A shower. Steal a robe. Okay, so we play the laundry set. We need to get that clock's not moving. It's moving too slowly. So I need to get a. Can I pick up the thing from the dock first? 1/3 screwdriver.
No, Rufus. I need the 1/3 screwdriver for the operation,
and I need it to randomly combine with items.
I said, hands off.
All right.
That's the top dock.
Doc.
Never mind.
I have.
You've kept the fog.
Okay, can't do that just yet. He isn't going. I can't obtain that. Right. So, from my inventory, which is dropping various things on me. Paper money, shampoo. Dustin Hood?
Absurd humor is okay in itself, but I can't waste this unique opportunity on another cheap pun. I'm thinking of the fans who love my pranks for their cryptic ambiguity.
Okay.
Could I bother you again?
Yes, you seem to have a penchant for that.
Okay. Can I have your robe?
Can I have your robe?
Are you nuts? There's absolutely no way I'm going to take part in your eerie apocalyptic sock off.
It is a purification ritual to cleanse you of your sins. It is a matter of symbolically washing ourselves clean of our sins before the end comes.
What sins? I'm busy saving the world. Strictly speaking, I'm sort of a saint, and I already washed this
one. Yeah.
I have seen it.
Oh, come on, let me a robe.
Oh, come on, give me your robe.
No, these robes are intended only for people who are...
Oh, spare me. I'm out of here.
I have seen it otherwise.
So I need to get him to...
I'm gonna put a stop to your bunch of superstitious yahoos.
But we aren't doing anything wrong.
Oh, of course not. You just want to call down the end of the world.
Oh, we do not. The end can no longer be stopped. All that is left to us.
I bet we can end it. Stop it.
I see. So you're getting hammered. A sort of rap party for the planet.
Quite the contrary. It is a matter of symbolically.
Yeah, same bit.
So just soft drinks? I'd rather go to the real Satanists.
Okay, he's got the fear thing, so we... I want your robe. It says so in the thing. The plan says I need to get that, which means I need to go in here and get... play the laundry set. and get the costume from the washing machine. I need to see his robe for that. For that, I need to get into the shower. So I can steal your robe. It's important stuff. Step these. Now, can you use shampoo on you?
What is that? Shampoo? Do I look like I have a problem with greasy hair?
It also helps against lice and dandruff.
Then you should hang on to it, shouldn't you?
Hey. I have no idea what these are for. Must have put the trigger?
No food before.
Are you fat?
No. But you should never go swimming on a full stomach. Crabs.
Swimming? What are you gonna do?
Well, it's a purification ritual.
In a laundry?
Yes.
Yes.
Too bad the hotel doesn't have a pool.
If it did, it'd probably be toxic. But anyway, when we come back, folks, we shall meander around a bit and see if we can solve puzzles. That's next time. So until then, I'll catch you all later. See ya.